Good evening, staff, parents, caregivers, families, and the graduates of 2020, our Laurie's senior class. Initially, I send my apologies for not being present tonight. However, my daughter graduates tonight and I feel I need to be with her. Upon reflecting on a message that I might leave the young men of the class of 2020 here this evening, I found my thoughts reflecting on my own journey and that of my extended family. I reflected on the ups and downs of life and the unique journey that we must all travel. It became apparent to me that the essence of a successful journey involves loving and mutually supportive relationships. Our 2020 school year has had many ups and downs, and I congratulate the boys on their sense of hope and gratitude. They have been a remarkable group of young men, and I hope that all find a sense of success in graduating here tonight. They have supported each other through their Laurie's journey. They have developed strong relationships. I thank all families for working in partnerships with our school to develop these young men. The boys are in the beginning of a new part of their journey, or as the Bee Gees may say, they are in the morning of their lives. I wish to play a version of the Bee Gees song In the Morning and highlight a specific message from this particular song.
In the morning, when the moon is at its rest, you will find me at the time I love the best, watching rainbows play on sunlight, pools of water iced from cold nights in the morning. Tis the morning of my life. In the daytime, I will meet you as before. You will find me waiting by the ocean floor, building castles in the shifting sands, in a world that no one understands. In the morning, 'tis the morning of my life. 'Tis the morning of my life. Of my life, the minutes take so long to drift away. Please be patient with your life. It's only morning and you've still to live your day. In the evening, I will fly you to the moon, to the top right-hand corner of the ceiling in my room, where we'll stay until the sun shines another day. To swing on clotheslines made by the yearning, 'tis the morning of my life. 'Tis the morning of my life. In the morning, in the morning, in the morning.
Verse 3 states, in the morning of my life, the minutes take so long to drift away. Please be patient with your life. It's only morning and you're still to live your day. To our young men, please be patient with your lives and know that you're all unique, valued individuals. You will make mistakes. You will occasionally begin to lose hope. However, I ask that you stay in contact with each other and continue to support each other after your formal Laurie's journey ends. A focused on others leads to a full and meaningful life. In a recent farewell to some exceptional Edmund Rice education principles held online, I was particularly struck by the retirement speech of one of our principals. He explained that he'd been a principal for over 20 years, with the last of his 9 years being at a school in New South Wales. He went on to explain that both he and his father had attended this college. He remembers receiving the keys on the first day that he took over the ownership and leadership of that college. He went to the archives room with his father, where they viewed his father's senior photo in the 1940s, in particular, his first 13 photo. It was explained that his father broke down in tears of pride to think that his son was now leading this college. The principal speaking had explained that he had never seen his father cry before this moment or even after this moment, and he had passed away some 3 years ago. From this day, the principal devoted himself to the people in the school community, and he left with a sense of pride and gratitude as he moves into retirement. He explained by giving of himself that he gained far, far more than he had given. As our boys move from the morning of their lives, I hope and pray that they will continue to live with love, hope, and gratitude, and indeed a sense of service. I would like to leave with a quote, perhaps two quotes, one from Dr. Seuss and one a prayer, perhaps a strange mix. From Dr. Seuss, "Oh, the places they'll go," final verse. "Kid, you'll move mountains, so be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai Ali Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way." And we pray. Dear Lord, keep us mindful that we do not travel alone, and that regardless of the journey travelled, we are always held in your enduring love. I wish the seniors of the class of 2020 all the best as they move from St. Lawrence's into the next stage of their life's journey. Thank you.